Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? I've had a bit of a busy night. Well, yeah, I suppose it was a kind of... It was a busy evening, rather than a night, I suppose. You will see the eggs in backpack there at the top. I now have 171 eggs. They're doing quite well. I've got several pallets of wool down at the sheep farm. And this next one is nearly full, so we'll be getting that one fairly soon. If you have a look at the grass that is in the cows, we are running a bit low. We're only 6 ton left. We're going to need some more grass in for them. And we're also going to need some straw in soon. And we do have straw bales in there, so we don't need to worry about having to get more straw bales. And we have our straw bale thingy, what, there. But we'll worry about that in another episode. We don't need to do it today. The question that I asked last week for this week was, which loader do you want me to get? Which wheel loader? Do you want me to get this Liebherr, this JCB, or the New Holland mod one? And some of you said the New Holland one, but overwhelmingly, most of you said JCB. I had a lot of votes, which is absolutely awesome, and everybody wants a JCB. So that is the one that I will be getting. I won't get it just yet, because we don't have enough money, and we don't quite need it yet. I may even hire it first, before we actually get to it. And that brings me on to this week's question. I need a new tractor. We established that the tractor that I've got can't pull that baler properly. We tried a slightly more powerful one, and that didn't work either. So the question is, do you want me to get a 500 horsepower Fendt 1050? What are these? Those are no good. So it's a 500 horsepower Fendt 1050, a 320 horsepower Deutz-fahr 7250 TTV Warrior, and I think that one looks pretty cool, actually. That is a nice little mod. Or, the last option that I'm giving you is this John Deere 8370R, which is a 370 horsepower. So do you think I need the 370 horsepower John Deere, the 320 horsepower Deutz Warrior, or the 500 horsepower Fendt? It's your vote, it's your game. Head down to the comment section down below, let me know which one you think is best suited to this map. And that brings me on to the next bit. I did a whole load of baling. I finished the bales. I finished the field down over there, which was field... let me just bring this up real quick. Field 11. I finished that one, and then I took it to field 16, and I did over there. And there's something really, really cool I want to show you. And at the moment it's saying, if you have a look, it says the Deutz-fahr is actually at 100% straw. It shouldn't be, but it seems to default back to a smaller bale when you exit the game and then save it. So I'm just going to run through here, and then I will show you what I have done. There we go. You look up across. Loads of bales. I did them all at 1.5 meter bales, so these should, in theory, all have 5,000 liters of straw in each one. I don't know if our bale is going to be, if our trailer is going to be able to automatically pick these up, because they are a little heavy. I did actually have two bales roll down through, and because our hedges don't have collision on them, they've rolled down through and gone into the next field, one that we don't actually own. There, you can see them just over there. So I will have to go get those two bales, which was a slight nuisance. But there was something else I found out while I was in the middle of baling, which is really, really cool. It's a nice little touch. It's just something small. Those of you who've used this chrome baler probably already aware of it, and I'm just going to nip into the next field and I'll show you what I mean. Yeah, two things. I did have the time on the wrong time. It is now at 5x speed, as it should be. I just changed it when I first started recording because I got it to the beginning of the day and then I wanted to wait until I started recording again. The other thing is, it's on euros. It shouldn't be. It should be on pounds because this particular map is in the UK. Perhaps I should have maps in the same country and then I wouldn't keep forgetting to change them. But anyway, yes, there is something really, really cool that I wanted to show you, and I'm hoping that it's going to work. I'm hoping that I've got the timing of it just right. Now, this is saying 100% straw, which I don't want it to say, but I think it's just going to automatically change things. Turn on baler, reset bale counter. It's on 69 bales. It's not going to let me change it unless I actually turn the baler on, which is a little bit annoying. So we will just have to do that, and then we'll see what happens. Press mouse for additional controls. I don't see additional controls. Oh well. Right. Turn that on, and it's now automatically wrapping the bale. which I didn't want it to do. And incidentally, we don't own this field. I just came in here to speak to the man that owns the field. Well, I spoke to the man that owns the field. I just wanted to complete the bale that I was doing. And it's not actually worked. I only had a little tiny bit, and that's now the 70th bale. So it doesn't seem to have worked how I was hoping it would. But if you have a look there, you'll see the net is almost empty. So it might work on the next bale. We're only going to do just a couple across the bottom. I did ask him nicely, and he did say that he would allow us to do just a couple of bales, just so that we could finish off. And I really want to show you this, because it is such an awesome touch to how this thing works. So this bale should hopefully go to the right size. Let me just get rid of that. And let me just bring it along. I'm just going to go along the bottom, and then I will turn and I will go back along the bottom so that we don't... I mean, technically I shouldn't be in here, but I did ask the owner, and he said it was okay. So, you know, in theory... Ah, there we go. Brilliant. That is what I wanted. That's all I wanted to get. That's all I wanted. Right. Exit the tractor. So, it's used up all the net. So what you've got to do is you come off of here, and then we open this door like this. We go up to the net, and then move net roll to lifter. So press X to do that, and that puts it onto that one. And then I press X again, and that refills the net. Now, you watch this. It puts it up, slides it over, pushes it. How awesome is that? That is so brilliant. I love this baler. There are so many little touches like that that are just superb. Absolutely superb. So let me just close that one. So now the net is full, and oh, that is excellent. I really love that. Right. Let me climb back on the baler, and it is now put the straw into the main chamber, but I don't want it to do that anymore, so I'm going to lift up the pickup, turn the baler off, and I will get off of here, and I'm also going to pick up the little bit on the back. There we go, fold the drop mat. Right, so I've got two bales in here that I will need to come and collect, and... I've also got the two bales down in the other field. We will buy this field at some point so that we can finish baling the straw. But for now, the man that owns it was very generous in allowing us to come in here and just bale two bales, which I think is great. We won't be doing anything else in this field other than collecting these two bales. Right, yeah, that bale is actually a bit smaller than the one over there. So that's going to be the next thing. The next thing we're doing is collecting up these bales, and we've also got pallets of wool that we want to collect as well. This tractor we have for... What does it actually say? Doesn't say... Oh, hang on. Maybe I need to just change... Right, extend rent time. I've got 6 hours and 32 minutes, so I hired it at lunchtime. So I got 6 hours left on this tractor. And I would like to have it for, I don't know, actually. We might use it for a bit longer. I'm not quite sure yet. We'll see. Because we've got the Lamborghini up there on the... Oh, great demand at pub for corn. Well, unfortunately, this map doesn't actually support corn, and we don't have corn anywhere. Even though it says we do, it doesn't actually support it. So that's kind of a nothing for us, unfortunately. I'll just come in through here. I have also kept the traffic turned off on this map because it is making a difference to the frame rate. The chickens running around the yard seem to affect the frame rate a little bit, but I didn't really want to get rid of them because I quite like having the chickens running around. If it becomes too much of an issue, then we might have to do something else about it. I'm assuming that the other reason that we're getting slight lag spikes and so on is because of the sheer number of mods that I've got in my folder at the moment. Perhaps I ought to do something about that. We'll worry about that another time. So I'm going to put this baler away. Actually, I'm just going to drive straight in here with the baler. And I'm going to park it right here. And then I don't need to really worry about it too much. I can just park it there. I have had someone suggest that I should get the PTO mod for this game. Which is actually a really good mod, and I am seriously considering it. I don't know if I will just yet. Right, what did I want to do next? I need to get... Well, I'd like to go and actually start seeding the next field. Perhaps we should do that before... Because we've got to go and gather bales. Tell you what, I'm going to leave this tractor right here. Switch it off a minute. And I'm going to head up to field 5. We've got the seeder up there, and I can make a start on seeding field 22, I think it is. I'm just going to run up alongside. We're going to have to buy our pickup soon. I'm not going to do it yet because there's a few other things I want to get first. This field is growing now. It's in two separate growth stages, which is a little bit unfortunate, but that's okay. We can live with that. So I will fill this seeder up and I will run it up to the field up there, and then we can make a start on planting that one. Well, I'll basically do what I did in the last field, and I will do a couple turns around the outside, and then, actually I think it was three turns that we did. The crop that you wanted me to plant in this field was barley, so we will switch to barley, and let me just pop out of cab so that we can see it unfolding and everything. I'll unfold it here, and as I did this only like an episode or so ago, I will actually, I'll do a little bit now, just so that you can see it started, and then I will go on and do three turns around the outside, and then set the hired help going, so we can get on with collecting bales. Now then, I want to lower it, and start it up, and we're away. Excellent. It's keeping to the edge at just the right distance for the first round. I think you sort of line it up with the wheel, roughly, and then it should be about right. But yeah, I'm gonna do this field, then we can go on and gather up those straw bales that we've got. Hopefully, they will fit on that trailer, because if they don't, I'm gonna have to pick them up with the loader, and I don't really want to have to do that if I can help it. Just about to complete the second round, and I've had some really bad lag spikes, and I suspect I've got a mod somewhere that is causing some issues. I've not had any issues on any other map, so I apologise if it sort of affected the quality of the video today. As a temporary measure, I have actually sold all of our chickens, so at the moment we have no chickens, and we've still got 171 eggs in our backpack, and there's two still to pick up. But at the moment we don't have any chickens, so I might buy those back at some point, I'm not sure. They're not essential to running of our farm, obviously, they're just nice to have. There we go, hired help has just now started. He's going to carry on and do that. And we're going to run down and collect the Deutz again and get that trailer and hopefully get some of these bales in. And I was wondering if maybe all the bales lying around are contributing to the lag, although I was experiencing some lag issues before that. So I suspect it's more to do with a recent mod that I've installed, and I have been trying several. So yeah, I'll get back to you with that on the next episode. But anyway, off to the baler. To the bale trailer. I do actually have a full pallet of wool down here at the sheep farm, so I'm just collecting this one a second and dropping it into this shed. That makes 5 pallets in here, so we should be able to sell a few of those. Maybe we'll do that a bit later on. After we've done the straw, we could come down and collect these 5 pallets and take those up as well and sell them. Right, I'm hoping I'm not going to need this one, so I'm going to switch it off and now walk back up to the other farm. Now I've got to get that trailer out of there without knocking all the bales over and without catching up on the posts and everything. Right, how am I going to do this? I think I backed it in through there actually last time. It wasn't easy putting it in here, I do remember that much. It's been a little while. Okay, let's back up here and hitch that one on. And hopefully we can just take it straight up here. Then, oh yep, it's come out. It's just gone past there. And which field do I want to do first? Let's just go to the nearest one, which is out here. We should be able to get out round here. Now, the lag has decreased a tiny bit. So I don't know if the chickens were contributing to it, but it's not that improved. So it's not just, it wasn't just the chickens. There is something else that is causing this lag. And I can see it affecting sort of the game quite badly, so I don't know how, what sort of effect it's going to have on the video. We'll find out sooner or later. Well, soon enough, I should say. All right, come round there. And now I'll get straight out to, ooh, did I just catch that? I think I caught something. We'll go straight out to this field actually just going to film this bit because I don't always film while I'm driving along. Sometimes I do, sometimes I just go from yard to field and skip out all the bit in the middle. And you do, especially when you've got a long trailer like this, it can be quite interesting trying to get round all the corners and stuff. And obviously you want to make sure that I'm not cheating and cutting through hedges, because this one you could, if you wanted to, just drive straight through the hedges. And I'm not the sort of person that would like to do that. I am one. Well, when we come out of here, we're either going to have to... I would say we'd back into that field there. Now, how are we going to do this? I could go straight into the field and then back up into that. I think that might actually be the best way to do it. I know that we don't... It's a quiet road there, so we should be okay. It's just that fence post there. As long as we don't catch that gate post. I think I need to shunt just a little bit because I'm going to get the gatepost over there now. So let me move over this side a little bit. I'm going to try and do this one from in cab. I don't always do my reversing in that from in cab. And I think I should do more of it. Right, let's come back up here. This is a fantastic trailer, but it is really long. Right, I'm back up. I'm going into the field. This is going fine. Now I can't judge where that bale is, so let's turn it. We need to change our load type, so at the moment we're on wool pallets. Toggle loading type, product type X. Tree sapling, board pallets, potato pallets, ROS trans. What's ROS? I don't know. I'll worry about that another thing. Right, hay square, square bales mix, straw round. Right, hopefully that's right. Straw round, right, start automatic loading. Yes, okay, the bigger bales do fit on this trailer. That is what I wanted. That was what the one thing I was really concerned about, was whether or not they would actually fit on this trailer. We can't go too fast. I can't remember what the speed is, and now I'm going to actually come out of cab so that we can see this. And you have seen me. Oh, I see. It's just that they sort of touch each other slightly. Like go into clip. Clip is the word I'm looking for. They clip each other slightly, which is what is how they all fit on there, which is actually really good. And I was wondering if it was perhaps all these bales, because they're slightly different than game standard. It might be these that have been causing the lag. So once these bales are gone, we may be okay. So I'm going to stay out of cab now while we load this, and I'll probably just load this one load on screen. And then I'll go and get the other lot of bales off screen, because we don't need to see that as well. I've got two bales down there that I've got to go and get. I've got to find the gateway for that field. I just realised I don't actually have a clue how to get into that field. So that could make things quite interesting. And how many have we got so far? We've got 13 bales on here so far. I did 70 altogether, and it's 20, I think it's 20 something that you can put on this trailer, isn't it? Might be less than that. More than that, rather. Right, there's one full load. I was saying 53%. Ah, and then you put a bit more. So it's over 30. Oh, too fast. Too fast. There we go. Hide. Oh, yeah, you can hide or keep the help. Right, well, I'll just get rid of it altogether for a minute. And I got two bales up there that I want to get. I want to get this one here. So I come over and get this one, and then move up here. It's slowing it down a little bit to go up and down these hills. I've got to get into that field over there. I'm hoping that there's another gateway somewhere. There isn't one from here. That's going to actually be quite difficult to get into that field over there, because I can get out onto the road easy enough, but it's whether I can get off the road into the next field, because it's sort of a straight line. That could be interesting. Is that a gateway right there? Oh no. I was wondering if for the corner of this field here, I did wonder if there was actually an extra gateway there. I don't think there is. Right. So I got that one. This one here and another one. So I can actually go into the next field. I'm running out of time for this episode, so I'm going to get into that next field. We are going to have to try and go out via the road now. This is the big question, is can I do this? Can I actually get out through here? Now, I gotta keep it at an angle, and I'm going to have to swing right into the bushes. That's as far over as I can go. It's doing it. Okay, we've got that first. We're out through the first one. Yeah, driving too fast. I am aware of that. Don't worry. Now, can I get into this next field? I got to get the gateway. And right, there's the gateway. I can just see it just coming up. So I need to swing out as far as I can. And that gate is going to be more difficult. Right, I'm going right into the bushes here as far as I can. This gate is going to be a lot more difficult because of where it is. I may even have to approach this from the other side. Not even close. Not even close. Look at that. I haven't got a hope of getting through there, have I? Right, now I'm backing right into the hedge. So what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to approach it from the other direction. So I'm going to go down the road, turn around, and come back again. I can turn in this grass field here. I come in. I'm probably going to annoy my neighbours big time if I keep driving into their fields and spinning round in their fields and that. Reversing into them, driving in them and spinning round. Yeah. I'm going to have to send them lots of eggs or something. Right, so we've gotten out of there just fine. So this time I can approach it from this direction and I need to get right into the hedge. I'm going to have to go in as tight as I possibly can. Right in tight, riding up over the bushes, and then come through here and get as tight over to that side as I can. Can I get through? Is it going to let me? It's tight. It's very, very tight, but I did it just. Right, that's okay. Now I got this little bale here. Is it going to... I want to just have a look at that, because that bale actually was smaller than the others, wasn't it? I just want to see how noticeable it is that it's smaller. Doesn't actually seem to make much difference. Right, that's stopped that auto-loading. I'll come up here. I'm aware that I now have actually run over time, so I apologise for that. I just wanted to get these bales. You can see the slight difference in the bales there. It is, you can notice it, so I don't know if we're going to get a difference when we come to sell them. I got to get this trailer out of here now, so I'm going to do that a minute. And then we're going to go and get those last two bales that are over in the other field. Oh, there's a gateway here, and it's right on this corner, but I've got to get round a couple of gateposts. I've got one gatepost there, right there, and then I got those there. I'm not... I can't even get around that one. I think what I'm going to have to do is go and get the loader and use that one and carry the two bales out of the field and put them next to the trailer and then use the auto load feature. I'm just going to drive up here and see if there's... Actually, I'm going to hop off the tractor and walk. This is going to be a lot easier. If I hop off the tractor a minute and I walk, let's have a quick run around the field and see if there's any other gateway besides this one, because I'm not going to be able to get that trailer in here, I don't think. Right, I've gone and collected the New Holland loader and I brought this one up. I'm not going to try anything fancy like two bales at once. I'm just going to gather up these bales one at a time. There's one. Take this back down to the trailer. And then we will auto-load them once they're down, both down next to the trailer. I'll leave the New Holland loader here for now. I'll put that away later on off-screen. We don't need to worry about that. All I want to do, because I'm very, very aware that we are now running over time. Oop, a bale's going to roll away again, isn't it? So I just wanted to grab these bales really quickly, get them onto this trailer. So I'll finish doing this, load up these two bales. Everybody knows how this works now. And then I will go and unload the bales into the straw power plant. And we'll see how much we get for them. Because these, remember, are 5,000 litres each rather than the... I think it's 3,000 litres for the 1.3 metre bales. Not quite sure, but I know one of those bales is smaller than the others, so that will have an effect on it. Right, there we go. Drop that one there. And stop. Climb out. Run through the hedge. Here we go. And if I just very quickly zoom back a bit so we can compare the size. Load those two on. That's full. And that one bale is noticeably different. And the strap does go across it. So I'm hoping, actually, that... this is what's causing the lag on this map, because I don't really remember much in the way of lag before we used this chrome baler, so it might be that this is the issue. So we'll see about that. I'll get this round into the field in there next to straw power plant, and then we can unload them. Right, I'm actually going to unload them like this rather than loading them in with the load all. And I know that this is kind of cheating, but you know how the load all works, and we've seen it all before. So I just wanted to do it like this so it would be a bit quicker and we could get the job done. So it would help if I loaded them the correct way, unloaded them the correct side. So how do I change the unloading side? Toggle side, right, so M, back, right. So that's the side that I want on the right-hand side. So I press O to unload them, and in they go. Right, that's 312 euro, well, it should be pounds, per bale. And, right, I caught them all. One of those is the smaller one, isn't it? Still see 312 going off there each time. 112. I'm sort of looking at the bales and looking at that up there. If anyone spots a different amount on one of those bales, let me know, because I want to see if we can actually get that one. So let me unload them again. Load them back on. Oh, 273. There was one there for 273. So it does make a difference for the bales. And oop, there. Right, that's the last five. So that's all of the bales unloaded. Let me just hop into here. So that's a lot quicker than having to use the load all. And already, I've actually noticed an increase in... It's only slight, but I have now noticed an increase in frame rate. So I suspect that part of this issue is because of the different size bales. So next time we use the chrome baler, we will stick to the smallest size bale. So it's the same size as those there, because those, I think, it's bigger bales. They affected it slightly. So anyway... Thank you very much for watching. Remember, this week's question is, which tractor do you want me to get? I do apologise for running over so long, and hopefully we'll be able to sort out this lag issue. But anyway, do you want me to get this Fendt 1050, which is a 500 horsepower tractor? Do you want me to get, where is it, the deutz-fahr Warrior, this black Warrior, which I think looks pretty cool, but don't let that influence you. I'm not trying to influence you this week. I do sometimes. You pick the one you want. So this one is 320 horsepower. Or do you want me to get the John Deere 8370R, which is 370 horsepower? It's your vote. It's your game. Let me know what you think. Let me know what you want. Before next episode, I will go and pick up the rest of the bales that are down in that other field. And I will bring them all up and I will sell them. And so that will be done. And we'll see if that has solved the lag issue. If it does, I'll buy back the 100 chickens that we've sold. I've really got to stop trying to wipe out all of my own barns. Not a good habit to get into. Right. Again, what am I catching on? Oh, I'm catching on that little thing there. So, yes, if you've enjoyed this episode, please head down below and give us a like. And if you really enjoyed it, please tell your friends all about me. That would be awesome. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.